businesses and they can't find workers because those same workers that's already, you know, outlined, that they're getting these extended benefits that are more generous than the pay that these businesses can offer them. And therein lies the rub. What do you think?
Well, Desiree's right in that this sets up a really interesting experiment in federalism here. You've got the states that are the laboratories of democracy, and of those four states that are going to be ending unemployment benefits early, the Republican states, there are other Republican states who are also thinking of doing something similar. And the argument there is that these unemployment benefits, they have run their course at this point. The argument is that they are subsidizing unemployment, and that they are widening the gap between employers who need labor and employees who need to return to the workforce. Meanwhile, though, you have the White House who has said that no, the
graduation. I could give a speech. I could just be like, hello.
Well, wait. It's going to pick up Mello. That's what it's going to do.
Hopefully.
It's going to pick up Griffin and Mello. Throw that in some
you.
getting a nice concert app when you're ready to see how it comes up and where it comes from. Okay, so grass, let's it up.
It's your choice. So how do you feel about that?
I think it'd be better if we sit just so it looks better.
I mean, it kind of depends on how you feel like you can project. Maybe you want to sit.
I think we're loud enough sitting.
What's that?
I think we're loud enough sitting.
Then you do a poll back there. It's your choice, okay, Kathy?
Poll, sitting or standing? Wait, Beth.
All right. Play twice as loud, Lennon.
You can have our microphone.
Elliot.
We have one back here. I think it's funny for us. He might be off.
You win.
Yes, I do. Let's turn this mic off.
So why don't you guys take out National Emblem in about 4 minutes?
Do it.
Just play it. In five.
Tilt it up.
I'm saturating National Emblem, basically.
Is that working out okay?
It just races each other by like.
Because when Meg was playing it the other day, we were getting
favorite laps.
Shot
11, best shot we got. 19. That increases my entire octave, actually.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah.
Like from alto 2 to alto 1.
I played 2. It's pretty awesome.
Let's face it, I don't even play the last game. Why not? No. Yeah. No. Yeah. No. Yeah. Play it fine. Just leave it. We'll keep it out there.
Hey. Oh, that. I don't know if I just use that.
What?
That
thing was iconic.
You know, I was angry about it, right? Yeah. I was angry.
I thought it was cool. It was funny. Yeah. It was my entertainment.
It was.
Yeah, we're all just like, we're like watching it go.
Yeah.
2 years ago, they had a
drama. Oh,
yeah.
So, let me have your attention. So, Ben, listen up. So even when we're not playing, people are kind of watching us because we're like in the plane of things to look at besides them up there. And so their seniors aren't going to get up and walk until later. So their kind of eyes are on us, eyes are on the camera singers. So if you're comfortable with, like, you know, your games and stuff, make sure the sound is off. But also, if you could kind of conceal it a little bit, like on your music stands, you know, you're good at that.
I have a better idea. Don't play games.
Yeah. See, President Catherine says do not play games.
Yeah. No,
just games. You know what? It's like it's cool that we're here. We're gonna listen to some. It's gonna be moving. Catherine's already having a hard time.
Yeah.
I know it. It's just gonna be a mess. Chase has he has Kleenex.
Yeah.
With lotion.
So you can hit him up. You didn't bring him out with you?
No, I haven't. They have lotion.
They're like the lotion ones. So
like eyeballs.
Well, that's all right.
Yeah.
It's okay.
might not appreciate it.
Look, it's Mr. Mix got you.
No place of hilarity. So it's windy. It's breezy. So you're going to have to pay attention to that. It's 5:15 right now.
So just keep in mind, I think we should play out more out here, especially the grass.
So anybody who has those parts of love. Don't play them so separate. Play nice and full. Yeah.
You want me to play that?
Well, you're on the, it's not a solo.
Okay.
It's all for all.
Okay.
Okay, so play it nice and loud.
I'm fine. Huh? How long is this going to take?
Sort of going for overhead, but more particularly overhead.
Yeah. Was that
fair? Sure. Okay, good. Now, is this an entire mic stand up tour? Is it just a head? Is it just this?
No, all these. Yeah, these are stands. Yeah.
One, two.
Can you roughly stand where we're going
to
stand?
This is definitely yours. This whole thing is yours. That's mine.
Yeah,
okay.
That's absolutely
yours. You got to be careful.
Yes.
Okay, can I make sure we don't take it?
Where do I?
Yes.
I'm going right here.
I don't know which
side. Oh, right. It's kind of like,
no, we're not.
Trevor stands right there. Trevor's right there.
Yeah, he's
like here. I don't know. Should I move up? Like, should I go here and then someone goes there? Trevor stood here and warm. Yeah, me too.
I don't think Trevor should actually be that close.
We're Trevor. We still love you.
How do we know? There's never. So guys are in three rows. Where are you guys if you're in three rows?
In 3 rows, I'm still here.
And then behind me is
Sarah. I'm still in the
and then McKenna and Nick are.
Because then I'm here.
Yeah.
So you're my right
now.
I'm busy. I'm just getting the arrangement right here.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. There we go.
Is
yeah, because you're in the front. You're right by the mic. I get to serve.
I like how they all your water.
Oh,
So I think we can more or less kind of do
it might be a bit, Trevor.
You can like take up an entire how about
I go places?
What? Sorry.
Sorry.
It takes a village.
Wow. One of them fell.
Shouldn't move like that.
Yeah, that's a lot of water. You put all of that in? Yeah, what's she doing? She's just standing around. Where'd she go? She was just standing around. I think we should start dancing right now.
class of 2021. Please be seated. Good evening. I'm Kimberly Calcasola, assistant principal for the class of 2021. Superintendent of schools, members of the Board of Education, district administrators, faculty, parents, relatives, friends, and members of the class of 2021. Good evening, and welcome to the 64th annual commencement ceremony for Granby Memorial High School. At this time, we kindly ask that you silence all cell phones. Please abstain from approaching the graduates during the ceremony, as this is a distraction from this very special occasion. At the conclusion of the commencement ceremony, we ask that everyone remain in their seats until all the graduates have left the field. The class of 2021 is now present and prepared for today's commencement ceremony. Officially opening tonight's ceremony, I'm pleased to introduce Student Government President Tyler Makowski.
I am pleased and proud to ask you to join me in our Pledge of Allegiance. Please stand and turn to the flagpole right of the graduates. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing as the chamber singers sing our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner
please be seated. On behalf of our high school administrators, we would like to take a moment to recognize our faculty, staff members, and parents who worked so intensely in preparing for this commencement ceremony. At this time, I'd like to call upon William Cayley, Natalie Schock, and Mark McWhorter, who would like to acknowledge very special groups of people in our audience this evening.
Good evening. Thank you all for coming to celebrate the graduation of Granby Memorial Class of 2021. My name is Will Cayley, and I'm speaking on behalf of our class to recognize the teachers and staff that have affected all students that are sitting here today. I would love to make this speech personal to my own education because there have been so many teachers that have influenced my life, mindset, perspective, outcome, and worldview. However, all of the students at Granby Memorial High School have been impacted and inspired by these teachers as well. Granby Public School System has educators that care about their students and the quality of our education. As we embrace our future challenges, we will remember the lessons, cherish the memories, and never lose sight of the core values you have instilled in all of us. Thank you.
At this time, we ask all parents and guardians of graduating students to please stand. On behalf of the class of 2021, I would like to extend a sincere thank you to all of the parents and guardians whose love and guidance has allowed us to be here today. We appreciate your support at athletic events, plays, concerts, and everything in between. We could not be here today without the time and effort you have devoted to our success throughout the years. We owe our future to your past efforts. Thank you.
I would like to ask all of the grandparents in the audience to please stand. On behalf of the Granby Memorial High School class of 2021, I would like to thank you. Thank you for everything you have done to help us get here today. Whether you live near or far, you have always been there for us to help however you could. Your continued love and support has touched us all and will continue to be touched by your love and support for the rest of our lives. Thank you.
At this time, I'm pleased to introduce to you Spencer Bennett and Aiden Goodrow.
Good evening. Aiden and I think that it is a fitting end for the educator selected by our class to give an address to finish her Granby Memorial High School career by giving a speech. Mrs. Schaefer has always promoted public speaking during her time here at GMHS, whether by teaching speech class or introducing the Poetry Out Loud program. She helped countless students improve their public speaking and manage speaking anxieties. Whether you had Mrs. Schaefer for freshman English, AP Lang, speech class, or writing with purpose and style, I think we can all agree that Mrs. Schaefer truly cared about all of her students, especially beyond the classroom, wanting each of them to succeed. Mrs. Schaefer has been able to make connections with her students and watch many of them grow and mature over their high school years.
Spencer and I have both experienced Mrs. Schaefer's passion for literature and language firsthand in classes we have had with her. Even with students who may have not loved English class as much as she does, Mrs. Schaefer still went above and beyond to try and engage them. I had always disliked analyzing literature and writing too, to be honest. I thought it just wasn't for me. However, that changed when I got into Mrs. Schaefer's classroom. She is one of those rare teachers who demonstrate a deep passion for what they teach, as well as for connecting with their students. I clearly remember 5 or 6 times when a random literature term would come up in class. Antithesis, for example. Oh, you guys really don't know what antithesis means? Her eyes would light up and she'd basically say, well, let me tell you, and would give us the best explanation. These little acts every day showed me how much Mrs. Schaefer truly cares about teaching. She is one of the best teachers I've ever had, and I'm incredibly grateful I was able to catch her final 4 years at Granby. Mrs. Schaefer, you are an inspiration to all of us and a truly amazing person. Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to welcome Mrs. Lauren Schaefer to the podium.
Thank you for that beautiful introduction, Spencer and Aiden. It wasn't just antithesis. There are other things that we talked about as well, but I'm glad you remember that one. My speech in some ways is going to be using that feature as well. We'll be talking about some contrasting ideas. Superintendent Grossman, Granby Board of Education, Granby Memorial High School Administration, my beloved colleagues, proud parents, family, and friends, and mostly to the class of 2021. You can applaud. When a student in one of my speech classes hinted a few weeks ago that I might be chosen as the faculty speaker, my first response was, I don't give speeches. I just tell you all what's wrong with your speeches. But when my selection was confirmed, I thought, well, there's cosmic justice or supreme irony for you. It had been my little secret all these years that I could teach public speaking all these years, including to about 100 of you just this year, without ever making a high-stakes speech myself. But now, here I am on the brink of retirement, delivering a graduation speech. The stakes are as high as they come. It's my final lesson to students. It's my most challenging final exam ever. You guys didn't have finals, but this is mine. And we're emerging from surely one of the strangest and most challenging school years ever. I ask myself, how could I possibly find the right words that could even begin to do justice to this occasion? Yet, despite my glossophobia, I was and I am deeply honored to be selected as your speaker. Just please disregard any public speaking rubrics we've used. Don't gauge my eye contact or my nonverbals, and just know that I've tried to craft this message from my heart for all of you. If you noticed, I removed my mask earlier when I began this speech, and I'll explain why that's significant shortly. But first, let me tell you a personal story. 45 years ago, I graduated from high school in Natick, Massachusetts. It was 1976, the year of our nation's bicentennial. And as most of my period one students just learned, surprisingly, that means 200 years. Now they know, another term. There's your shout out, by the way, period one. Okay. We graduates back then were proud of our country and we were excited for our future. I had smart and talented friends. My boyfriend was the president of our student council, and I had won a prestigious community scholarship. I was headed off to Smith College. But I had a secret that few people knew. My parents had separated midway through my senior year, and I was reckoning with a slew of family troubles, struggling with being away from home at a time when my very concept of home was breaking down. I lasted just 2 months in college. I went back to Natick. I worked and volunteered, and I grew up quite a bit for the rest of that year. I enrolled at the University of Pennsylvania the following fall to make a new start. For the longest time, whenever the transition from high school to college came up, whenever I was talking to people about the time in life that you're in right now, I wasn't fully truthful. I told people I had taken the year off between high school and college, rewriting my narrative and leaving out the reality that I couldn't handle so much change at that point in my life. It was safer to tell my story that way. You could say that with my secrets, I was wearing a mask of sorts. And to be honest, whether it's a real mask like these that we've been wearing for the last 15 months, or the facades we put on every day for the good of the social order, masks do give us protection. They keep us safe. They let us engage with others in the different roles we play. We're different at school than we are at home, than we are with strangers. Pretty much on a daily basis, we lie, we mask, we wear facades. Masks also can keep us from embarrassing ourselves. You guys all remember the iconic balcony scene from Romeo and Juliet, right? Juliet passionately confesses her love for the boy she's just met basically minutes earlier, who happens to be the son of her family's mortal enemy. It's the Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou, Romeo line. And she doesn't know that he's right there below her. When he makes his presence known, she is shocked, and Juliet tells Romeo, "Thou knowest the mask of night is on my face. Else would a maiden blush bepaint my cheek." And let's not forget, they met at a masquerade. at a masquerade party where they could hide their true identities. Masks can help us feel like we belong, even under challenging circumstances. You all read Fahrenheit 451 last year. Rather than put out fires, firemen set fire to books, which have been outlawed because they are thought to cause unhappiness. Toward the beginning of the novel, when that manic pixie dream girl, Clarice, asks the fireman, Montag, if he's truly happy, he realizes he wears his happiness like a mask, which can melt away like a candle. Taking off that mask makes Montag an outcast in the dystopian society of Bradbury's novel, and he ends up running for his life. Of course, Montag has good reason to want to reject his repressive society, and we admire him for his courage. He's a descendant of another American hero many of you admired, Henry David Thoreau. Thoreau's civil disobedience is a hallmark of American history, and I hope you will always have the courage to stand up for your beliefs. But let's face it, there are times when conformity keeps society running productively. We literally could not have made it through this year without our masks. We have worn them, whether we wanted to or not, to protect ourselves and the people we care about. Societal institutions like schools or the military or the workplace need conventions and rules to function. Think about what happened to those poor boys in Lord of the Flies without them. Social conventions or facades do have their value. When you launch your post-high school lives, you will want to put your best foot forward and make a good impression. You may want to make a fresh start. There may be parts of your story from high school that you choose not to tell your college professors or your supervisors or your new friends, and that's okay. You will likely test the waters to find what and who feels right. This is completely normal and part of becoming an adult, to put your best face on when embarking on new adventures. But, thesis statement coming up, what I want to stress to all of you is that long after this pandemic is over and you move forward on your life journey, you should still remember, metaphorically or symbolically, to take mask breaks and to show others who you really are. Alan Moore, the creator of Watchmen and many other graphic novels, has said, "You wear a mask so long, you forget who you were beneath it." One of the positives from this crazy year is that in the midst of every, or almost every, interminably long double period class every day, we would walk away from those carefully sanitized but impossible to see the board through shields, step outside or into the community gym, and remove our masks. And here's another secret. Did you know your teachers enjoyed those mask breaks as much as you students did? Maybe more. Not only did we get to see what our students actually looked like, but we got to chat with you and watch you do the grade 12 version of recess. You soaked up some sun, you talked about your lives outside of school, and some of you read some poetry aloud when I offered you extra credit, and maybe you even enjoyed it. In your lives ahead, find the people you can take your masks off with and have fun with. Take off your mask and laugh. Finally, find the people with whom you can remove your masks, open up to, and be your genuine self. The last assignment in speech class, as many of you know, was to craft a farewell message. Over the past week and last January, many of you shared powerful life lessons with your classmates. You expressed your gratitude for your friends, your families, your teachers and coaches, and you reflected on your growth through your school years. Now, as you leave this very special school and this very special town, I think Jack DeGray earlier called it a town with a small town with a love vibe, a loving vibe. Where's Jack? Did I say it right? Loving town with a small town vibe. Something, I didn't write it down. Anyway, it's a special place. As you leave this place, you're no doubt excited and hopeful. but you may also be feeling vulnerable and insecure, uncertain. I certainly felt that way at your age. And in truth, these feelings never fully leave us. We need people who will love and support us for who we are, not for what we are. And if you are fortunate to have family and loved ones now who let you take your masks off and show that vulnerability, you'll want to appreciate them and not take them for granted. And if you need help in showing your true self, it's okay to seek out support and lean on others when you need to. If this pandemic year has taught us anything, it's empathy. My own journey has taken me many places since that difficult time after high school. I got to know a young man I had barely paid any attention to in college, and we've now been married over 36 years. I started one career in book publishing, but after having my amazing daughters, I knew I would rather share stories with young people than edit the work of adults. So I became a teacher and came to Granby 17 years ago. Here I found a welcoming and warm community and the most worthwhile work I had ever done in my life. I'd like to think I've left a little something behind with many of you and your siblings and neighbors. I am reminded again of a moment from Fahrenheit 451. The leader of the renegade book people in the forest tells Montag, "It doesn't matter what you do, so long as you change something from the way it was before you touched it." Class of 2021, you and I are leaving this place that has been home to us for many years. I hope you will all find what it is you want to change and where you want to leave your mark on the world. But to find what or who you truly love and to make your impact on this world, remember to take regular math breaks. I love you, GMHS.
What do you guys think? Did she pass? She passed her final? All right, excellent. Thank you so much, Mrs. Schaefer. At this time, it is my pleasure to introduce the chamber singers who will sing And So It Goes.
In every heart, there is a sanctuary safe and strong to heal the wounds from lovers past until a new one comes along. I spoke to mistake, so I will share and you can have this heart to break. Ooh. Choice were mine to make, but you can make decisions too, and you can have this heart to break. Ooh. Ooh. And so it goes.
A very special academic award is made to a graduating senior who, in the opinion of the faculty of an entire department, has demonstrated unusual and meritorious achievement in all aspects of study in that particular department for 4 years. The colors presented to selected students will be presented by the department's coordinator or representative. At this time, will the departmental scholars for the class of 2021, along with the department representatives, please approach the stage. In the art department, Ms. Holly Heck presents the Multi Blue Scholar Cord to Elena Speliopoulos. In the business department, Ms. Sue Clark will present the Brown Scholar Cord to the recipient, Alexis Klein. In the Family and Consumer Science, Ms. Sue Clark will also present the Royal Blue Scholar Cord to Dontell Williams. In the Technology Department, Ms. Sue Clark will present the Gold and Maroon Scholar Cord to James Akutura. In the English Department, Ms. Linda Touchette will present the White Scholar Cord to Luke McFarland. In the Math Department, Ms. Margaret Bastiance will present the Gold and Blue Scholar Cord to Chase McGee. Chase is also receiving the Gold and Black Scholar Cord from the Science Department, presented by Ms. Jackie Patton. In the music department, Ms. Mindy Shalansky will present the Light Blue Scholar Cord to Nicholas Boyd. In the physical education department, Ms. Nancy Giaguone will present the Green Scholar Cord to Tomas Makaset. In the social studies department, Mr. Rodney Scuttle will present the Orange Scholar Cord to Tyler Makowski. And in the world language department, Ms. Karen Richmond-Gadar will present the White Scholar Cord to Caroline Burnett. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you the department scholars for the class of 2021. Please welcome to the podium, Principal Michael Dunn.
I would say good evening, everyone, but this is a perfect evening. And I cannot tell you how amazing it is to see you and be with you all this evening. Before introducing the salutatorian and the valedictorian for the class of 2021, would all members of the World Language Honor Society please stand to be recognized for their scholarship, character, leadership, and service. And now, would all the members of the National Honor Society please stand to be recognized for their scholarship, mask break, character, leadership, and service. And now, in special remembrance of why we are named Granby Memorial High School, would all students committed to serve in the U.S. military after graduation, please stand and be recognized for their character, leadership, patriotism, and service to our nation. Thank you very much. Before I announce our salutatorian and valedictorian, I would like to congratulate this exceptionally high-achieving graduating class with an unusually high percentage of students whose grade point averages exceed 4.0. It gives me great pleasure and pride to announce our salutatorian for the class of 2021. One of this amazing young man's teachers describes him as amongst the most intelligent, disciplined, and talented students I have had the pleasure of teaching, always seeking to learn, equally committed to supporting his classmates. This student excelled in a remarkable 12 AP classes, and when he actually ran out of sequenced calculus at GMHS, he took multivariable calculus and differential equations through the University of Southern New Hampshire. A participant and finalist for several years in the Poetry Out Loud program that Ms. Schaefer had everything to do with bringing to us, this year he was our school winner who went on to regionals and somehow finds time to manage both soccer and basketball, play the drums for one of our school bands, and serve as a member of the Congressional Youth Cabinet under Congressman John Larson. Our department scholar for both our math and science departments, his yearbook quote sums up this young man's amazing future. How can the sky be the limit when there are footprints on the moon? Congratulations to the salutatorian of the class of 2021, and look out Yukon, and look out moon and beyond. Here comes Chase McGee. It is with great pleasure that I announce this year's valedictorian for the class of 2021. And it's hard to imagine a more well-rounded student. Described by his teachers as a hardworking academic powerhouse and a strong and humble leader, he is the winner of several awards, including the Superintendent's Award in eighth grade, the Principal's Cup last year, and the CIAC Scholar Athlete Award this year. A seven-letter athlete recognized statewide for his leadership on our varsity baseball and hockey teams, he is also president of student government and a member of DECA and National Honor Society. It is remarkable this student found time not only to take our most challenging classes, including nine APs, but to excel at each at the highest level. And last year, on his own accord, he helped a student from Guatemala who spoke very little English, using his fluency in Spanish as well as his fluency as a kind and connected student to help make this student feel at home. I am proud to announce that this year's Social Studies Department Scholar for 2021 is also the valedictorian for the class of 2021. Congratulations and all the best at Tufts, Tyler Mikowski.
Just for the record, they don't know about this until they come on stage. It gives me great pleasure this evening to introduce you to our symphonic band who will perform the musical senior selection entitled Rock Encounter, conducted by Mr. Mark Neary. Thank you. Nice job, guys. Each year, a member of the senior class is selected based on their literary ability to capture the spirit of the senior class in words. It is my pleasure to invite Lauren Roy to the podium to deliver the student address. Hello, everyone. Thank you, Superintendent Grossman, Principal Dunn, Board of Education members, faculty, staff, students, and families for this opportunity to address the great class of 2021. To say our high school experience, especially the latter 2 years, has been anything short of a roller coaster would simply be a lie. When stepping foot into GMHS as scared, timid freshmen 4 years ago, we knew little about what was to come in our near futures. Life, with its natural ups and downs, would take journeys deep into valleys, over the tops of mountains. To define our high school experience by COVID-19 and the massive hurdle it placed in the road would be unfair. Thus, I'll encapsulate our path as high school students charging forward through a global pandemic and a few things we learned along the way. First, adversity won't stand in your way if you don't let it. We began the school year last fall in what seemed like an alternate reality. Some students were home, some at school, clubs were canceled or met virtually, and sports practices were as chaotic as ever. College application deadlines were lurking, and we often couldn't find an open SAT site. And we didn't know from one day to the next if we would get that quarantine call home. November rolled around and our perseverance shone through. Our sports teams won 3 NCCC championships, we applied to our dream schools, got our first college acceptances, held a virtual coffee house, and first and foremost, persevered through the entire experience. Now, in the spring of 2021, all that hard work in the fall has paid off, and we're headed everywhere from Maine to Texas, to North Dakota, to California, and everywhere in between for college, career, and the military. In arguably the toughest recruiting season in NCAA history, 15 student athletes in the class of 2021 are participating in collegiate athletics. That adversity barrier, we sailed right through it. Second, challenging yourself pays off. I've never met a more hardworking and ambitious group of people than my classmates. I never thought I'd see so many people willingly decide to take AP chemistry or be at the athletic fields on the weekends, putting in extra work on their own. Many students balance academics with part-time jobs and family responsibilities, while still others look for ways to pursue their unique interests while much of the world was shut down. The will to be the best student and person you can be radiates through our class. It looks different for everyone, but whether it be taking that next level class that's out of your comfort zone or pushing yourself just a little harder than you did last semester, the desire to make the most of personal potential is clear among the GMHS class of 2021. Third, things happen as a blessing or to teach you a lesson. While we all have had different academic and personal journeys through high school, there are a few experiences the class of 2021 almost definitely has in common. meeting our best friends, discovering our passions, succeeding as teams and individually, being lucky enough to be taught by some of the best people we will ever meet and will never forget. The little things like passing that test we thought we'd fail, sunny mass breaks with no wind, our favorite meal on the menu for lunch, feelings of accomplishment when that last assignment of the year was turned in. The lessons came in waves, but happened for a reason, as everything does. We stayed isolated from each other for months, which made our reunion all the more sweet. As things started to return to normal this spring, parents enjoyed the first band and choral concerts in over a year. Fans weren't limited at games, and we're able to have this in-person commencement ceremony with family and friends here to celebrate our accomplishments. We learned that we can get through times that seem unbearable, though it seemed impossible in the moment. All of these lessons have prepared us for whatever curveball may come our way as we embark on new, uncharted futures. It won't be easy, but if our experience at GMHS has taught us anything, it's that we can handle the unprecedented. Good luck, GMHS class of 2021. We're ready to change the world.
I want to thank both of our Laurens, Lauren Roy and Lauren Schaefer. Can we get another hand for both of them for their beautiful words? And you are indeed ready to change the world. Granby Memorial High School class of 2021, I am proud and honored to say a few words to you tonight in presenting you for graduation. First of all, I thought that you all looked amazing last night, but you also look amazing tonight. I'm not sure that you have ever had a more drastic wardrobe change within 24 hours. And you are amazing because you know how to roll with the changes. Do you remember what I told you yesterday when we were at rehearsal and I showed you the picture of the crescent sun that was being eclipsed by the moon? You guys remember that? Remember what I said? Who remembers? Yes, the universe is smiling on you. And tonight we are smiling back. The reason you can handle the unprecedented is because you, class of 21, are indeed unprecedented. First of all, no other class graduated the night after prom. I'm so glad it was as awesome as you because that's what you deserved. But also, none had to miss homecoming or an entire football or wrestling season or struggle to see teachers through five layers of plastic or through a buffering screen or sing through masks. No other class had to present capstones through Google Meets or work as much on Google Classroom while teaching your parents how to use those things. But even through all this, class of 21, as Lauren pointed out, you still won championships. You still excelled in the arts, drama, music, DECA, robotics, and live streamed coffee houses, concerts, and plays. As I've said before, no other class had as many lemons thrown at them, but made as much or as sweet a lemonade. Class of 21, you have become the faces of flexibility, rock stars of resiliency, champions of challenge and change. In fact, no class had to stretch their minds, hearts, or comfort zones quite as much as you. You've heard me use this phrase before. Since you were freshmen, it's how I've summarized our ultimate goal. What we're all about is to stretch your minds, enlarge your hearts, and widen your comfort zones. And it's our continued homework as you embark on this next phase of your hero's journey. But the hard part is that the only way to do all this stretching is actually the hard parts themselves. The hero's journey fits tonight because graduation is one of those thresholds from the familiar into the unknown. Recalling the Odyssey from ninth grade, I was an English teacher like Mrs. Schaefer. It's all about the obstacles we must face and overcome in order to grow. The Romans said, per aspera ad astra, through adversity to the stars. It's why Hell Week is called that. It's why we use weights working out. And it's why we give you, on purpose, challenging texts, tough math problems, unfamiliar languages, We aren't trying to be mean. In fact, just the opposite. We challenge you precisely because we respect you. We know you can do it if you work hard. And more importantly, because the world into which you embark is a mess of complex problems we need you to help solve. But as Lauren stated, the challenges pay off. They stretch us. And the ultimate paradox is that we become fulfilled only by emptying ourselves for others. What Tennyson, in his poem about Odysseus, calls one equal temper of heroic hearts. We often think of heroes in the movie version, Bruce Willis in Armageddon, saving Earth and humanity in one grand self-sacrificing act. But much has been said about heroism in the more ordinary and even unseen ways when someone simply cares enough and responds to a need of someone else. It's this smaller collective heroism that got us through to today. The sacrifice, the hard work of individuals on a team, and certainly our amazing teachers and staff have shown heroic hearts this year. Class of 21, you too have shown heroic hearts in the countless ways that you have stretched, seen a need, and followed your heart to help. I'm blessed to have known about half of you since your fifth grade year, and almost all of you since your sixth grade Nature's Classroom. The other day, one of you recalled our first conversation about leadership in fifth grade. And I can't tell you how many times I've seen this person de-escalate a tense situation or help to get a job done or simply brighten someone's day. I met one of you at Nature's Classroom when you had trouble sleeping and the dads and I played cards with you. 5 years later, I watched this same person at our last homecoming spot a freshman sitting alone, invite him to join his friends on the dance floor. I've seen some of you deal with tremendous loss, and I've seen so many of you have each other's backs and show the heroic hearts of Granby Bears. As you'll leave us, you'll need to stretch again beyond your comfort zones. And like that first amphibian crawling up on that scary shore, it's the only way we evolve, but evolve we must. I'm not exactly sure that's the science behind it, but run with it. How do we do this? When faced with other challenges, and they will come, other crises, and they will come, will we sweat the small stuff? Or will we adapt as you have? Will we see the big picture, but also the people right in front of us? Our final homework is to continue to shine our core values to guide your hero's path. Never stop seeking to understand the world, others, and yourselves, working to the best of your ability, especially when challenged, keeping open minds, especially when you disagree, treating others with kindness, and recognizing that your words and actions truly do matter. Keep at this. Practice it until there's no problem your stretched minds can't think through. No need of others that your enlarged hearts can't care about. No challenge your widened comfort zones can't embrace. Class of 21, you've got this. You've already set a new bar through your flexibility, resilience, compassion, and creativity. So continue to evolve our world one unprecedented graduated Granby Bear at a time. We have never needed you more, and the universe is smiling on you. Congratulations, and we love you. Now it gives me great pleasure to welcome for the first time as superintendent to an in-person graduation, Granby Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Jordan Grossman. And Dr. Grossman, it is with deep pride that I present to you the unprecedented Granby Memorial High School class of 2021.
So this is what it looks like. Members of the Granby Board of Education, family, friends, incredible staff of the Granby Public Schools, and finally, the amazing Granby Memorial High School class of 2021. I feel honored and humbled addressing you today as you complete your wonderful journey through 13 years of education, culminating with high school graduation. As you have never graduated from high school before, I've never given an in-person high school graduation speech before as a superintendent of schools. So this certainly will be a night that we both remember. Looking back at this school year, I just have to take a minute to pause and take a deep breath. I don't know about you, but I haven't taken an opportunity to pause this entire school year. So I'm just going to pause. Looking at you on this championship stadium field in Granby Pride Maroon, I truly cannot believe we made it to this day. Please know that every decision that I needed to make, and there were many difficult decisions, I owed it to you to make it the best possible senior year that we possibly can make. And I promise you, although you are leaving the hallways of the Granby Public Schools, we will always remember you, and we will always be there for each of you. Last week, I had the opportunity to sit down with members of the Granby Memorial High School class of 2021 and ask them two questions. One, what are the best things about the Granby Public Schools? And if you were the superintendent of schools, what would you bring to this outstanding school system? Just on a side note, I'm pretty confident to say that there's someone sitting in this class that will be a superintendent of schools. Class of 21 responded with the following answers. Teachers and staff that actually care. Wonderful athletic, arts, and technology programs. Granby is just such a wonderful community. There's a sense of kindness, compassion, and equity. We don't feel like a number. Here we go. If you were the superintendent of schools, these are all quotes. Dr. Grossman created boys volleyball team. Dr. Grossman allows students not to wear masks in the fall. Dr. Grossman, do not have quarantining in the fall. Dr. Grossman, have a field day. High school field day. Finally, and my favorite response of them all, Dr. Grossman, no disrespect. I wouldn't want your job as a superintendent of schools. Thank you for providing me the words of advice. I will never forget our time together, and I'm grateful to be your superintendent of schools. This class of 2021 had an incredible impact on the Granby Public Schools. You'll be remembered as a class that excelled in and out of the classroom, a class that cared for one another, a class that transitioned to remote learning during a pandemic overnight, a class that during your senior year of high school had to follow new CDC guidelines such as mask wearing, a class while maintaining social distance, while you were navigating hallways with arrows, a class that was able to participate in outdoor musical concerts, a class that was provided lunch for free every day, a class that created a live stream news station, a class that held virtual coffee houses and virtual theater productions, a class that won NCCC and state championships during a pandemic, and finally, a class that never complained about all the new rules and guidelines that were asked of you during your senior year For that, from the bottom of my heart, I am eternally grateful and thankful for your support this year. The Granby Memorial High School class of 2021 is truly a special class that this superintendent of schools will never forget. Granby Memorial High School class of 21, I want to challenge you one last time. In the next 48 hours, 5:36, please consider writing a note of thanks to your family members, teachers, coaches, friends, and other important people in your lives who help guide you to become the person that you are today, a Granby Memorial High School graduate. Thanking people along the way will serve you well with your future endeavors. Granby Memorial High School class of 2021. Last year, virtually, I started a new tradition that the superintendent of schools presented each graduate with a gift. I will continue that tradition this evening. For your dedication to studies, leadership, athletic accomplishments, artistic talents, and caring attitudes, I will be making a donation in your honor to the Best Buddies International of Connecticut. Best Buddies International is a nonprofit organization dedicated to establishing a global volunteer movement that creates opportunities for one-to-one friendships, integrated employment, leadership and development, and inclusive living for individuals with intellectual and development disabilities. This will be an honor to do that on your behalf. Granby Board of Education, it gives me a sense of pride and enthusiasm to present to you one of the greatest classes in the history of the Granby Public Schools, Granby Memorial High School class of 2021. These students have fulfilled all the necessary graduation requirements to receive a diploma from the Granby Public Schools. Ladies and gentlemen, I am now pleased to introduce the Granby Board of Education Chair, Sarah Thal, who will present the Board of Education congratulatory remarks. Mrs. Thal.
I know I stand between you and your diplomas, so this will be very quick. Good evening, class of 2021. You did it. You made it. And here we are. In person. On behalf of the Granby Board of Education, congratulations to you, your families, your teachers, and to all who helped you along this journey. It has been a year, but remember, this is just 1/13 of your K-12 education. Whether you began in the Granby Public Schools as a kindergarten student, or if you joined us new at Granby Memorial High School, this past year is just a fraction of your education. And yet this year has been so impactful. Education has never been challenged like this. Our students, families, teachers and staff, and the entire Granby community have not only risen to the challenge, but have persevered. I figured in homage to the pandemic, I would cite a source familiar to many of us here today, Netflix. And more specifically, my recent binging of Grey's Anatomy. I think you all may be able to relate a little bit to spending more than just a little time watching TV this past year. I found my inspiration for the graduates joining us today in season 5 of Grey's Anatomy when Becca, a patient who is nearing her graduation, shared these words. Today's the day my life begins. Today, I become a citizen of the world. Today, I become a grown-up. Today, I become accountable to someone other than to myself and my parents, accountable for more than my grades. Today, I become accountable to the world, to the future, to all the possibilities that life has to offer. Starting today, my job is to show up wide-eyed and willing and ready. For what? I don't know. For anything, for everything, to take on life, to take on love, to take on responsibility and possibility. Today, my friends, our lives, or your lives, begin, and I, for one, cannot wait. So congratulations, class of 2021, and as the great Michael Scott from The Office once said, may your hats fly as high as your dreams. I'd like to welcome Michael, Principal Dunn, back to the
Thank you, Mrs. Thrall. And now for the main event. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2021 is now ready to receive their diplomas. As principal, it is with great pride that I present the Granby Memorial High School class of 21.
Aiden James Goodrow. Mark Allen McWherter. Natalie Claire Schock. Spencer Aaron Bennett. William D. Cayley. Tyler John Makowski. Nathan Daniel Abrahamson. James Bryant Akatura. Dina Fiorina Alfaroni. Jackson Dudley Alleman. Olivia Nicole Ash. Samuel Hartford Askew. Brandon Tyler Babineau. Julia Michelle Bado. Elizabeth Lynn Baker. Mason James Blackburn. Michelle Blake. Owen William Bogley. Sophie Jane Bolton. Daishan A. Bonner. Nicholas Harmon Boyd. Laura Bro. Zachary R. Brewer. Tara C. Briggs. Margaret Jane Briniger. Evelyn K. Brook. Avery Elizabeth Bryanton. Madeline Buckman. Samantha Jane Ayotte Bull. Caroline Louise Burnett. Anthony Mauricio Canellis. Aniela Grace Cashman. Robert Joseph Chamberlain III. Owen Thomas Contreras. Ashley R. Kuhn. Jenna Elizabeth Cox. Owen Richard Danke. Ty C. De Los Reyes. Cameron A. M. Deer. Jack Thomas DeGray. Riley Daner. Colin DeRocher. Thomas DeLugalinski. Sean C. Dowd. Lila D. Dowu. Angela Maria Everett. Tyler Cameron Fairchild. Adeline Brooke Feedy. Matthew Thomas Farrow. Ryan Reginald Fett. Devin Walker Flagg. Logan Scott Fleabot. Avery Flint. Adam Ezra Florian. Carter Allen Frith. Jordan Marie Garcia. Abigail Luce Gaucher. Zachary R. Gillespie. Madeline Ann Gilmore. Matthew Gins. Cameron X. Gravlin. Gianna Maria Grimaldi. Lauren Ashley Hartman. Tristan Sincere Hogabook. Ethan Luke Hennebry. Megan Kate Hennessy. Landon Marshall Holcomb. Max Edward Hollister. Jacob Joshua Ivanov. Aiden Kaska. Eleanor Karabetsos. Grady P. Kelly. Madison Hope Kennedy. Abigail Grace Kidd. Aria Ray Kingsley. Eric B. Kingsley. Emma Gail Kirkpatrick. Alexis Emma Klein. Olivia Lucia Cole Morgan. Isabel Crum. Janaya Anira Leggett. Grace Claire Lemoyne. Jose Diego Leon. Patrick A. Layden. Paige Elizabeth Lisowski. Hannah E. Lloyd. Anna K. Lombardo. Benjamin Lawrence Longest. Tanner Lupoli. Tomas Lorenzo Macasai. Abigail Ives Maher. Spencer K. Malley. Braden C. Mandeville. Caitlin Mandeville. Jonathan William Marler. Simon Daniel Matthews. Luke J. McFarland. Chase Bartholomew McGee. Sarah Elizabeth McTeague. Anais Medina. Alexis Lynn Meyer. Colby Dwayne Milbrandt. Hunter M. Miller. Evan Joseph Naparata. Susan Christine Newman. Alexis Sarah Nichols. Devin Wesley Nielsen. Thomas Negri. Nina Lee Nolan. Adeswa Nicole Okoro. Zachary Freeman Orlock. Lee Allen Owen. William J. Pagliaro. Veronica L. Papil. Jonathan Mark Platty. Elliot Alphonse Plourd. Catherine Elizabeth Sutka. Cameron James Rathka. Jordan W. Reichsa. Jake T. Rivard. Maya L. Rivard. Carmelo Anthony Roberts. Elliot F. Rogers. Dylan A. Rooney. Lauren E. Roy. McKenna Lee Ryan. Reese Dylan Samulis. Riley Marie Shalansky. Holly Elizabeth Shine. Elena Luisa Speliopoulos. Cody Brooks Sprofke. Ryan G. Stone. Logan G. Tangway. Christian Noel Thompson. Daniel Albert Scripple Toth. Leon Dylan Totten the fifth. Sky Trunts. Harlem Van Cole. Linus H. Waskin. Megan Marie Wasick. Eddie Weber. Dontell Trammell Williams. Kylie Noelle Williams. Clay Jesse Willis Swan. Anna Wicks. Sophie Ann Zachara.
Do you want to do this?
Woohoo!
Oh, hey now. Those will come off in just a moment. At this time. It's a perfect night. We can wait. At this time, Aiden Goodrow, Mark McWhirter, Natalie Schock, Spencer Bennett, William Cayley, and Tyler Mikowski will come forward to direct the entire class to move their tassels from their right side to the left side of their mortarboard, symbolizing their graduation from Granby Memorial High School and the hope of the upcoming class. Would the class of 2021 please stand?
Go ahead, Natalie. Yeah, get your tassel. Give him a minute.
All right. Okay, will the graduates please return to their seats? Once again, congratulations to the Granby Memorial High School class of 2021. We love you, we will miss you. We are now at the end of our commencement exercises. We have the honor of having Mr. Steve Moore marshal our graduates from the stadium with his ceremonial bagpipes. We kindly ask that you remain seated until all of the graduates have exited the aisles and have proceeded to our turf field. Thank you very much, everyone. Have a wonderful wonderful evening.
Yes. Can these gentlemen get?
Right.